to City Hall and how it moves through the process to the eventual count that is shown on the screen.
Marissa, let's talk about the ballots for just a minute here. How many, do you know at this point how many absentee ballots have been received? And based on that, what does that tell you about voter turnout?
Well, I had an opportunity this morning to visit the polls. Mm-hmm. And some of the feedback that I got from the poll workers, they thought that the turnout was a little low right now. But I went in the afternoon. I went back in the afternoon, and then I started seeing lines. So really, you know, it's our first election, so I can't really tell you exactly what that means, other than there was a difference between the morning and the afternoon. We do have 43,600 registered voters. Approximately 21,000 of those voters, registered voters, are absentee voters. And out of that 21,000 number, we have received approximately 9,000 absentee ballots mm-hmm. that we'll be counting tonight.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And if you haven't already gotten a chance, you still have time to go out to vote if you're a registered voter. The polls do not close until 8 o'clock, as Marcelo mentioned. Right now it's a quarter till, so you still have 15 minutes to get out there and vote. Right now we want to give you a live picture of council chambers. As Marcelo and I mentioned earlier, it is being called Elections Central tonight, and as you can see, there are members of the public here, deputized staff. You can feel the energy in the room. Polls, again, don't officially close until 8 o'clock. Marcelo and I will return with you live, with live coverage and live results in about half an hour. I'm Rachel Senes with City TV. We'll see you in about half an hour.
Thank you.
I'm Rachel Sennis with City TV Channel 18. Welcome back to our special program, Voice Your Choice 2007. You are watching live coverage of the City of Santa Barbara's general municipal election. Now, the polls are officially closed. They did close at 8 o'clock tonight, and by the end of the night, we will have the semi-official results of the city's election, three city council member seats, as well as Measure A. And right now, we want to give you a live picture of council chambers right now. As you can see, there's a lot of activity going on around us, and to help explain it all, joining me tonight is the City of Santa Barbara's Administrative Services Director, Marcelo Lopez. Marcelo, thank you for joining us tonight.
Rachel, I'm excited to be here. It's a festive occasion for us. We're running the election, and it's very exciting, you know. We're waiting for the numbers. We're waiting for those numbers.
Mm-hmm. And so, Marcelo, we mentioned that the polls did close at 8 o'clock. That was about half an hour ago. Well, what's going on right now in council chambers? We mentioned that it is being called Election Central.
Okay, well, what's going on right now is that we're beginning to display the count on the absentee ballots. What we have 33 polling locations, and we have 5 mail ballot locations. We are tallying that information, and we are displaying it on the screen at this time.
So at this point, this is a packed house here. Obviously, there are so many people here. There are members of the media, the public's here to watch. Some of the council candidates are here. This is really a transparent election.
Absolutely. You know, you've seen the way we do it. You're seeing it live and following your ballot and understanding how it's processed. You'll see that, you know, there's not a lot of activity right now on the inspection board because, and that's the folks in the background that are sitting on the dais. The reason for that is because we're still waiting for the ballots to come in from the poll locations. When they come in, then you'll see a flurry of activity. You'll see a lot more things going on. But at this point, we have received approximately 9,000 absentee ballots, and those are the ones that are being counted. The information is being processed. We anticipate that once we get the first set of data in the system, it will start going a little bit faster. But, you know, in all reality, we're still waiting for the ballot information, and it's all going to come together at some point.
And Marcelo will ask you some more questions in just a few minutes about the election process and procedure, but let's back up a little bit and get some background information on this election and take a closer look at why the city is holding this standalone election. This year is a significant one for the city of Santa Barbara. For the first time ever, the county did not conduct the city's elections. Instead, the city held its own standalone election. The reason for the change? Simply to save money.
At the city's request, the county presented the city with a cost estimate related to conducting the city's 2007 election. That cost estimate was between $550,000 and $650,000. In comparison, the County of Ventura estimates the cost to conduct the City of Ventura's election to be approximately $95,000 for a comparable election with a higher number of registered voters.
With savings of nearly 50%, the city wanted to maintain the same level of service to the community as in past years. The city contracted with Martin and Chapman Company to help with election logistics and hired an elections consultant. Poll workers and inspectors have spent the last few months training with the city on proper voting procedures. All day, Santa Barbarans have been filing into polling places all over the city to voice their choice and help determine who will fill 3 city council member seats and the fate of Measure A, a charter amendment that would change the city's election from odd-numbered years to even years.
Well, I think voting's important because that's how change comes about. It's something that whether you want to see change in the city or if you don't want to see change in the city, one way to get your feelings about that across is by voting.
In a democracy, we choose our leaders. And each individual voter may not get the result he wanted, but he's part of it. And if they don't vote, they're abdicating their responsibility and their privilege.
For those of you who cast your vote, you are not only a part of democracy, but history as well, by voicing your choice in the city's first ever standalone election. And we are back here live in council chambers. Joining me is the City of Santa Barbara's Administrative Services Director, Marcelo Lopez. Marcelo, we just heard a little bit about why the city is holding the standalone election. What should the public know about election process and procedures?
Well, you know, what the public should know is that we don't just run an election and decide the rules for ourselves. There's an elections code that we follow, and that's a very important part of this process. The elections code lays out the different procedures, the different requirements that have to be met to run an effective election. And you will note that there are a lot of checks and balances in this process. As an example, we operate with a rule of two. The rule of two means that every transaction will involve at least two persons. Two persons that are working, bringing in the ballots up here for the counting. Two persons at least that will be receiving and inspecting, doing the initial inspecting of the content of the ballot box. There'll be two persons. You see folks at the dais. They will be reviewing each precinct, the ballots from each precinct, and then they'll make a determination and send it on forward so that they can be counted.
Mm-hmm. And Marcelo, you did make a good point. You did mention that everything is detail-oriented and mapped out, and we want to show our viewers a couple of maps here of De La Guerra Plaza, because this is really a secured access area. Not only is council chamber secure here by the ropes and the presence of police officers, but De La Guerra Plaza as well. What's the map we are looking at right now?
Well, what you're seeing on the screen, at the bottom of the screen, is City Hall. And right now, the front entrance that is facing De La Guerra Plaza, it's closed to the public right now. The entrance, the official entrance to the public, is 735 Anacapa Street. But on the other side, where you see that horseshoe shape, that loop that coming in, it's closed now, so with access limited to the folks that are coming in from the polls. The poll workers that are delivering the ballots, the supplies, all of the materials that they were given to work on this election. Mm-hmm. And they will be bringing them to the steps of City Hall, and they'll be transported up here to the chambers and begin the processing of inspection mm-hmm. and eventually counting.
Mm-hmm. And what is this map we're looking at right here, Marcelo?
Well, this is a layout of the council chambers. And if you see that that arrow at the point, at the top of the screen, that's a dais. And that's where the inspection board members are going to be sitting, and they are sitting right now, and waiting for the ballots to come in so that they can inspect them. But if you go just to the left of that arrow, the top of that arrow, on top of the on the screen, and you go down, there is a little table on the side. That table is for the purposes of receiving the ballots and inspecting the content to make sure that everything that we require to count the ballots has been received. That area has been cordoned off, as well as the two front pews here at the chamber, with access limited to the folks that have been deputized mm-hmm. to be able to be close to the ballots and process the ballots according to their particular assignment. Mm-hmm. They each have an assignment.
Mm-hmm. And just looking behind us, this is a packed house, but there's no communication between the public and the board members.
That's correct, with the exception of some of the announcements that are made by the city clerk or that I would be making myself tonight. There is no contact with the folks that are working there from the public, with the exception of the people that are the official individuals handling the election. And the two persons that are handling the election principally are city clerk Cindy Rodriguez.
So just to reiterate again, the public is invited to come watch this process.
And we want them to come.
We want them to come, exactly. And so the entrance is 735 Anacapa Street, not De La Guerra Plaza. That is blocked off.
That's correct. Now, once we receive all of the ballots, mm-hmm. once we receive all of the information from the polling locations, then we'll open it up. Mm-hmm. But until we receive all of the ballots, that will be an area for access limited to the poll workers.
Mm-hmm. All right, thank you for that information, Marcelo. Right now, let's take a look at some statistics pertaining to this election. The number of registered voters, there are 44,361 registered voters and 33 polling places, all of which are closed as of 8 o'clock.
As of 8 o'clock, they're closed.
Right, and the people behind the scenes, the poll workers and inspectors, 158 poll workers and inspectors. Marcelo earlier mentioned board members. There are 65 board members that are in charge of the receiving and processing. And Marcelo, the city of Santa Barbara is not alone when it comes to running its own election.
Not at all. You know, we're one of approximately 66 other cities in the state of California mm-hmm. that do a process very similar to what we do, mm-hmm. which is hiring individuals or companies that have all of the equipment and the infrastructure to put together the ballot to help us with all of that information, send it out, and ultimately count the ballots here at the council chambers at Election Central.
Okay. All right, Marcelo, right now we are looking at a live picture of council chambers, but we do want to get to the results. the results are is what everyone's anticipating right now. You can also get these results on sbcityvote.org, www.sbcityvote.org. Marcelo, these are the first of the results that we are looking at right now, the semi-official election night results. We have Dale Francisco with 2,730 votes.
And Mr. Litton at 926, and followed by Brian Barnwell at 2,517.
Mm-hmm. Helene Schneider has 2,912. Frank Hotchkiss, 2,342. And we saw the numbers just change as we speak. We saw flash on the television.
And we'll continue going. Bob Hansen has 366, mm-hmm. followed by Doss Williams at 3,536.
Mm-hmm. Michelle Giddens is listed at 2,833 votes, while Michael Cooper is listed with 457. Moving on to Measure A, it looks like yes for Measure A, 2,809 votes.
And no is at 3,653.
And there's about 13% of the precincts reporting. But Marcelo, what are these numbers that we're seeing now, though?
These are the numbers principally, as I can see right now, and I'm looking over my shoulder on the screen here at the council chambers. And what I'm seeing is that it's principally the absentee ballot information. Mm-hmm. So we don't have any completed precincts that I can tell for the... involving any of the other ballots we cast at the polls. So we'll have to come back with that additional information in a few minutes and bring you up to date.
Okay, let's take a look at those numbers once again, because I know people at home are anxious to see what those what the results are so far. The council candidates. Now, I do want to mention that these are the names as they appear on the ballot, the order they appear on the ballot. If for some reason you have to step away from your television, you can also get these results on www.sbcityvote.org, www.sbcityvote.org. Those are the latest results. Keep it right here on CTV Channel 18. Marcelo and I will return in about half an hour at 9 o'clock with more live coverage and live results. Right now, we want to give you a live picture of council chambers. You can see a lot of activity is going on. The energy is increasing here. Thanks for watching. I'm Rachel Sennis with City TV, and we'll see you in about half an hour.
Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Rachel Asenis with City TV Channel 18. Welcome back to our special program, Voice Your Choice 2007. You're watching live coverage of the City of Santa Barbara's general municipal election. The polls are now officially closed. They close at 8 o'clock tonight. By the end of the night, we will have the semi-official results of the city's election, 3 city council member seats and Measure A. Right now, we want to give you a live picture of what's going on here in council chambers. You can see a lot of activity is going on behind us. Joining me tonight is the City of Santa Barbara's Administrative Services Director, Marcelo Lopez. Marcelo, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Rachel, it's my pleasure to be here with you tonight.
Marcelo, this is a packed house. Tell us what's going on right now.
Well, a lot of excitement is going on right now. And what's happening is we have now closed the polls, as you've already announced. We are receiving and have been receiving the ballots from the polling locations, and those are being processed. They're being received, they're being inspected, and they're being counted. And it's unfolding. We're about halfway there already.
And aside from this packed house, members of the media, public here, deputized staff, we are hearing a lot of talking, but we also hear that noise in the background. I don't know if the folks at home can pick up on that, but what is that noise?
Well, the noise is the machine that's counting the ballots, and you can hear the shuffle. Pretty much like a very loud deck of cards, and they're being scanned through this machine, and they're being counted, and then the results are being posted for the public to see. Mm-hmm. And that's what, you know, you've been seeing on television this evening.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of ballots, Marcelo, a lot of voters wonder what happens to their ballots after the polls close. So let's take a closer look now at the journey of the ballot.
After the close of the polls, the inspector and one clerk from the precinct board returns the supplies and ballots to City Hall. They park in the reserved parking in De La Guerra Plaza on the east side of City Hall in front of the City Hall steps. The unloading crew, consisting of 2 staff members, assists in unloading ballot boxes from the car and proceeds with 2 police officers through the double doors. Once inside City Hall, the 2 runners then take the elevator just to the right of the entrance up to the top floor of the building. They then walk down the secured hallway to the left door of the council chamber and place the ballot boxes on the table located in the council chambers posted as Ballot Receiving Board. One runner assists in unloading voting booths and ballot boxes and placing them in the office adjacent to the council chambers once they are inventoried by the ballot receiving board. The ballot receiving board then checks in the large ballot box containing the supplies, the red box, white box, and green striped envelope containing ballot security. They inventory the number of booths and give a receipt to the unloading team, who then delivers it to the precinct inspector in the car.
And we are back here live in council chambers here in City Hall, 735 Anacapa Street. Marcelo, we just saw the journey of the ballot box. Everything during this election is mapped out and detailed.
Everything has been mapped out, has been very detailed, and then we're showing it to the public. You know, you might be seeing the whole mechanics of an election, but I think one of the effects of what the folks are going to be seeing tonight is a closer, more of an attachment to the election process. And we hope that this is going to spark more interest in the community to get out and vote. It's a very exciting process. It is a right that we have as citizens of this country to be able to vote. And we need as many people to get out there and vote. Hopefully, this will be a process of education that will encourage others to come out and vote in the next election.
And Marcelo, we are hearing a lot of noise in the background. It's the voting machines. Talk to me about how there's a backup and a backup to the backup, really.
Well, you know, we want to make sure we're able to count the ballots tonight. So we have one machine that's working, then the other one, there's a backup. Should any of those machines fail, we already have other machines that we can put up mm-hmm. and quickly replace them so that we can continue the count. Mm-hmm. And the count is an important thing right now.
Mm-hmm. It is. In other words, you have a plan B and a plan C if there's something were to happen to this machine.
Absolutely. We're equipped right now to be able to continue should one of the machines begin to fail for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm. And we have a couple of maps we want to show everyone at home right now of De La Guerra Plaza. This is only deputized staff allowed. What are we looking at right now, Marcel?
Well, what you're looking at is that horseshoe entrance to the De La Guerra Plaza, and that entrance is now, that access is limited to the people that are transporting the ballots to be counted here this evening. And you see that the horseshoe up on top of the screen mm-hmm. is facing the entrance, the principal entrance of City Hall. But that's where we're receiving all of the ballots, and ultimately they make their way up here mm-hmm. to City Hall.
Mm-hmm. And we were just downstairs, Marcelo, so really there is a secure presence, deputized staff, and a police presence here.
Yes,
City
there
Hall
is.
Tonight.
Yes, there is.
Mm-hmm. All right, now we have a few statistics to go to really quickly pertaining to this election. In terms of registered voters, there are 44,361 registered voters and 33 polling places, all of which are closed as of 8 o'clock tonight. There are also 158 poll workers and inspectors, 65 board members that do the receiving and processing of ballots, and also the city of Santa Barbara is not alone running their own election. Over 60 California cities run their own elections.
Yes, they do.
Mm-hmm. Let's go right now to the results. Everyone's been waiting for these results, Marcelo. Let's take a look at these results. And all night we've been calling them semi-official. Can you explain that a little bit? It says on the screen, semi-official election night results.
Well, they're semi-official because they're not official until they're certified, and we have to go through a process to certify the count. So at this point, they continue to be semi-official. You know, and that's what we do on election night mm-hmm. until the whole process is certified.
So, Marcelo, what do you want to tell us about these numbers here?
Well, as you can tell now, we have over 63% of the precincts that have reported. And so the count begins to be sizable at this point, and the numbers are becoming more pronounced. When we were at the 52% mark, it meant that out of the 38 precincts, there were 20 that had already been counted. So this number where you see the 63.16 is the aggregate count that also includes the five mail locations. There's a total of 38. We've been talking about 33. 33 is the number of polling locations, but we also had five additional mail locations where people were able to mail their ballots. And this is because the precinct numbers are so small that you handle those by mail. So the overall count includes that, but that's a pretty small number, the five we're talking about. The significant numbers, and then the number 33 of the polling location. Mm-hmm. And we're already, as you can tell, over 50%, over 60% mm-hmm. this evening.
Mm-hmm. And if we could just look at those numbers again, we saw that flash on the screen. The numbers are continuously changing.
They change as we tabulate. And once we finish a precinct, then those numbers show up on the screen. Unfortunately, it's not really visible, but there are some white letters right below the measure A and the precinct reporting. That would actually give you the number of precincts that have been reported in total, because otherwise you see a percentage versus the actual number. But the percentage suffices at this time because it shows you that we'll be finished the count when we get to 100%.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And as we're looking at the votes right now, these semi-official election night results, the names on your screen are as they appear on the ballot. So when you cast your vote today, this is the order of the names. It looks like Dale Francisco has 4,952 votes. Daniel Litton, 1,550.
Brian Barnwell has 4,464. Helene Schneider has 5,133.
Mm-hmm. Frank Hotchkiss looks like he has 4,221. Robert Hansen, 603.
Doss Williams with 5,770.
Mm-hmm. Michelle Giddens with 4,637. Michael Cooper with 4,637 votes. Moving on to Measure A, there's a yes and no on the ballot. 4,581 votes for yes for Measure A.
And the no is 5,988, and that's at this point with 65.79% of the precincts reporting.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, Marcelo. Those are the latest results. Keep it here on City TV Channel 18 for continuing coverage. Marcelo and I will be returning in about half an hour with more live election results. Right now, we want to give you a live picture of council chambers here at City Hall, 735 Anacapa Street. There is still time for if you're sitting at home and you want to watch the Democratic process take place. You can still access City Hall through the 735 Anacapa Street exit. Not the Delaguerra entrance.
Correct.
But the Anacapa Street entrance.
There
I'm Rachel Senes with City TV. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in about half an hour. Good evening. I'm Rachel Sennis with City TV Channel 18. Welcome back to our special program, Voice Your Choice 2007. You're watching live coverage of the City of Santa Barbara's general municipal election. Now, the polls have officially closed. They closed at 8 o'clock tonight. They were open at 7 o'clock this morning. And right now, we want to give you a live picture here of Council Chambers here in City Hall. It is being described as Elections Central tonight. And joining me tonight is the City of Santa Barbara's Administrative Services Director, Marcelo Lopez. Marcelo, it is about 9:35. What's going on right now? The polls closed at 8 o'clock.
Well, the polls closed at 8, and we have now processed a large number of ballots, and I think we have completed over 75% of the precincts reporting already. So we have a pretty good count so far. We're almost we're at the last quarter of the election.
Mm-hmm. And Marcelo, speaking of ballots and voters, all day people have been filing into polling places. And let's take a closer look at what their voting experience was like.
It's dark and the polls are closed. Do you know where your vote is? If you participated in the city's standalone election, you can rest assured it's being counted at City Hall as we speak. With 33 polling places across the city, Santa Barbara voters came tonight to voice their choice for 2007.
I think it's really important for our voices to be heard, and the only way our voices can be heard is if we take a stance on initiatives that we feel are important.
But their opinion matters, and they have somewhat of a say as to what happens and who's in charge, who makes the decisions for us.
And people found this year's voting process to be as easy as pie.
Very smooth, very quick. In and out.
It was pretty straightforward. Yeah, I knew who I was going to vote for, and the ballot issues were pretty straightforward and simple. I just walk over and come in and check in with the volunteers and get my ballot and sign off on it.
Okay. Thank you.
Once again, I forgot to turn in my absentee ballot, and so I just came in and dropped it off, like I always do.
Whether people noticed or not, the biggest difference this year was the fact that the election was run by the city instead of the county.
It's actually been a lot of fun, and we've had a fairly decent turnout. I'd like to see a lot more young people. I think the city's doing an amazing job.
When you participate in a democracy, every vote counts.
If we don't vote everywhere, Santa Barbara, North Carolina, Alaska, wherever, we give up our most basic right as citizens. Particularly in a small community like Santa Barbara, you can feel the impact that you have as a single voter. But I think sometimes on the national scale, we often don't have that sense that we're actually going to make a difference in a single vote. So it's important for us to come out and do our civic duty.
Well, it's always important to make your opinion known, and we are just trying to give our kids the best city we can, so if we have an opinion about it, then we should definitely make that effort to get out and vote. So, I did.
Now, for me in Santa Barbara, there's a lot of things going on that are affecting the quality of life and the quality of this community, and I think that we are presented with some significant choices this election, so it's important that if you care about where Santa Barbara's going, you vote.
And back here live in Council Chambers, Marcelo, we're hearing that noise again from the voting machines. We just heard from several voters and what their voter experience was like. What steps has the city taken to ensure a successful election process?
Well, we began the planning process for this election earlier this year, and actually late in 2006. Once it seemed like that we were going to be running our own election, we began the whole process. We laid out every step by month, by activity, culminating in today's election, and we have followed that plan to a T. It's a plan that's based on the Elections Code. The Elections Code articulates what it is that we have to do to run an election, and we followed it. not only very closely, but we followed, we're in full compliance with the elections code. A lot of security, a lot of training has gone into this election. The people that you see inspecting ballots have received training twice. The people that are working at the polls, we had two large sessions where training was conducted. I frankly learned a lot attending those training. We really have planned it, and prepared it and executed very well. I'm very pleased with Cindy Rodriguez, who's our city clerk. She and her staff have done a wonderful job of keeping up to date with the elections laws, the requirements, and not only the planning, but also the execution. Mm-hmm. You know, now we're talking about 9:30, and just a little bit after 9:30, and we're nearing conclusion of the election count. Mm-hmm. So we feel very good about it.
That's right, Marcella. And earlier, just a few minutes ago, it was a packed house here in council chambers. Now it's getting late, so a lot of people have left. Let's talk about transparency a little bit. What steps has the city taken to ensure that this whole election process is as transparent as possible?
Well, one of the things that we did this year is we invested also time and effort in doing voter outreach. So we put out a lot of information early on to encourage the voters to come out and vote. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a lot of effort went into that. At the same time, we decided that we should televise the election as we're doing now. So televising was a big part of this process. And in addition to that, we opened it up to the public. Mm-hmm. You know, the public could come and see the whole process. Typically, this is not seen behind the scenes unless you make a special request, because it is open to the public. But, you know, when you count the ballots, the paper, and you hear the noise and you have something to process and see, we thought that this would be a good opportunity to make it available to the public. You've seen the security that we have in place, police officers all around, and we have segregated areas only for deputized workers. But at the same time, you know, it's just a great opportunity. Come to City Hall, take a look at the count, and hopefully we'll encourage people to become more informed about the election process, to read their ballot pamphlet, to become more familiar with the issues, and participate in this great democratic process that we enjoy in this country.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of democratic process, what kind of feedback, we've been here all night here in Council Chambers, Election Central, and City Hall, what kind of feedback have you been getting from the public? What has been their reaction about this entire transparent process?
Well, they've enjoyed it. You know, and part of what went on tonight, when we could, we stopped and gave an explanation to the public as to what was taking place, because you know it is pretty standard. It flows very smoothly, but a little explanation goes a long way in understanding the larger picture. Mm-hmm. So we gave a little bit of that explanation, and people really like that. I received some feedback from the people that were here that one, they have enjoyed the process, seeing it, and now they have a better understanding of how the ballot travels from the polls to ultimately the screen where it is counted.
Marcel, let's take a few minutes right now to look at some statistics about this election here today. There are 44,361 registered voters, 33 polling places, all of which are closed. They were officially closed at 8 o'clock, as we mentioned earlier. Poll workers and inspectors, about 158 poll workers and inspectors, 65 board members. Those are the people who are in charge of the receiving and processing of the ballots. And also, Marcelo, the city of Santa Barbara is not alone when it comes to running its own election.
No, we're not alone. There's over 60 cities in California that run their own elections, and we're one of them now, and they follow a process very similar to what we're doing. They all have to follow the elections code, but you know, the only differences are probably the people and maybe the location, but pretty much it's a standard process that is followed.
And let's take a look right now at the results that are also available on the website, sbcityvote.org, and see where those numbers stand.
Yes.
The council candidates, as well as Measure A. And I just want to reiterate that the names you see on your screen, this is the order as they appear on today's ballot. We have Dale Francisco at 5,660 votes, Daniel Litton at 1,721 votes,
Brian Barnwell at 5,133, Helene Schneider at 5,886,
Frank Hotchkiss at 4,820.
Bob Hansen at 659.
Doss Williams at 6,578 votes. Michelle Giddens at 5,260 and Michael Cooper at 669 votes. Moving on to Measure A right now, there's a yes and a no.
And the yes is 5,227 and the no 6,888. And one important statistic at this point right now is that we have completed counting 86.84, almost 87% of all the precincts. So, I mean, it's 9:45, and I'm very pleased that we've almost completed the count at this time. We might be finished before 10, and our expectation is that we might even go into 11 o'clock. Mm-hmm. So things are going really well. We're very pleased so far with what has taken place.
Good point, Marcelo. Those are the latest results. Keep it tuned in here to City TV Channel 18 as we give you a live picture of Council Chambers Election Central tonight here in City Hall. As you can see, the board members are still busy at work. The areas are still closed off here in Council Chambers. The secure access areas, only deputized staff are allowed in. Now, tune in to hear City TV Channel 18 for continuing coverage. Marcelo and I will return in about half an hour. I'm Rachel Osenas with City TV. We'll see you in about half an hour. evening. I'm Rachel Sennis with City TV Channel 18. Welcome back to our special coverage, Voice Your Choice 2007. You are watching live coverage of the City of Santa Barbara's general municipal election. And joining me tonight is the City of Santa Barbara's Administrative Services Director, Marcelo Lopez. Marcelo, there's quite a difference here from a packed house earlier on, just a few minutes ago, to what we're seeing now.
Well, there sure is, and the reason for that is because we have now completed 100% of the votes that were to be counted this evening. Mm-hmm. There are a number of ballots, absentee ballots that were received at the polls, and some provisional ballots. It's estimated about 1,500 of these remain to be counted, and they'll be counted tomorrow.
Okay. And speaking of those results, Marcelo, let's take a look at those results right now. The latest semi-official results we want to see, and shortly it will be on your screen. As you mentioned, they are semi-official, Marcelo. And as we're looking at the council candidates, we do want to mention that this is the order that it appears on the ballot. Dale Francisco, 6,290 votes. Daniel Litton, 1,874. Brian Barnwell with 5,725. Helene Schneider, 6,539 votes. Frank Hotchkiss with 5,319. Moving on to Robert Hansen with 724 votes. Doss Williams, 7,315. Michelle Giddens with 5,802 votes, and Michael Cooper with 694 votes. Moving on to Measure A, there's a yes and a no. Marcelo, what do we see?
Well, on the Measure A, yes is 5,804, and on the no, 7,554. And this is 100% of the precincts reporting this evening.
Okay, and Marcelo, let's reiterate these semi-official results. We've been calling them semi-official all night. Why do we use this term?
Because the election results have to be certified, and until we finish that process, we can't call them final.
Mm-hmm. Marcelo, any thoughts you want to wrap up on this whole transparent election process?
Well, a couple of things. Let me add one additional piece of information. In terms of the overall voter turnout, we had a voter turnout of 32.6%, and it's compared to some elections in terms of the number. But that's what we had tonight, 32.6. Transparency, I hope that this broadcast, as well as the visitors, were able to enjoy how the process is carried out in an election, how we count your ballot once you've gone to the polls. That, to us, was a very exciting part of the process. I, for one, enjoyed it, and particularly since everything went as planned, and we're actually finishing the count ahead of schedule.
Mm-hmm. Is there a big sense of relief for you?
A tremendous sense of relief. You know, we were looking forward to November 6th, but more so to November 7th.
And it was months and months of planning. This didn't happen overnight.
Months and months of planning and preparation. And again, I mentioned it earlier, but our city clerk, she did a tremendous job, and her staff, in putting together this program, in putting together the plan, not only the planning, but also the implementation. And this is critical. And this is a process that's done in the fishbowl, if you will. Mm-hmm. It's a public process. Everybody gets to see it. It is very transparent. Mm-hmm. That was our objective. That's what we have accomplished. And tonight we completed the count ahead of schedule, which I'm very pleased to report.
Thank you for that, Marcelo. And speaking of transparent, you can also get these results on the website, www.sbcityvote.org. You can see that website address on your screen, sbcityvote.org. And that does it for our live election coverage for the City of Santa Barbara's general municipal election. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Rachel Asenas for City TV. Have a great night.